I probably only have one thing that might come above sleep in terms of things I enjoy doing.
Snacks.
Yeah, snacks. So between footy finals, spring picnics, family barbecues, entertaining season well and truly here.
But instead of dragging out the sad old cheese plate, we are taking your... Now, you say it for me because you say it better.
Charcuterie board.
Charcuterie board. Is that to right? The next level with award-winning butcher, Josh Pezza-Perry. Morning, Josh.
Look at Josh. He just looks capable.
You do look capable.
You just look capable.
Well, tell us... And this looks magnificent. Talk us through the basics. Let's start with the basics. What do we need to make a charcuterie board?
You've gone too far.
OK, sorry.
Sounded great, charcuterie. The basics for me, obviously, is plenty of meat and a bit of colour, as you can see, beautiful colour, a bit of fruit, the olives, the sweetness, the cheese, the bickies. As long as you've got the mixture and the plate looks full, everyone seems happy.
OK, load it up.
I could listen to you all day talk about charcuterie. You just sort of make it really accessible and Aussie. So what's going on with these? What are these twiggy sticks?
So they're my twiggy sticks. We're in a little town in Tassie, so just a small little butcher shop, family-run butcher shop.
What have we got in those?
Twiggy sticks. I can't tell you all the secret herbs and spices.
If you can't tell me, can I have a sample?
Yeah, try them. Best in Australia, so... I think they're great.
Sweet Mary.
So they're just like a small salami stick
Sweet
or a beer
Mary.
Stick or something like that. Got some real nice goodies. Fresh Tasmanian pork.
Oh, delicious.
What else could you ask for?
So delicious. I want the olive. Not too salty. Just perfection.
Oh, yum. Nice. Olives are beautiful too. Okay, if you want to go real luxury, what sort of flavours should you look at?
Yum.
Well, the luxury, it's obviously we've got the Brazola here from the Matadora.
What's that?
It's the Brazola, but this is made by the Wagyu, so it's a cut of beef. We're changing from the pork into the beef, the eye of the beef, and you can see that beautiful marbling in that. Look at that, you know.
Stunning marbling.
And that's dry aged and got that beautiful colour. You know, we get into some nicer salamis and just jazz it up a little bit more. You've got that, I guess, the dearer end of the meat, and it's been aged a little bit longer and gives you that finer taste.
And all the little bits, like the sprigs of rosemary and the bits of rocket and stuff, so you can use that to fill it up, which would cut down a little bit on cost, I would imagine.
Yeah, well, that's it. And it just makes the board pop out, you know. If you've got some friends coming around, you want them to enjoy the whole experience of coming and having a charcuterie board. It wants to look really good as well as taste really
nice. Josh, when you bring these out to people, like, does the conversation stop and people just look at you with reverence and then fall into a round of applause?
Yeah.
Is that what happens?
I think they love it. There's no doubt. They can see the time and effort you put into it.
Yeah.
And then... we just go for it, you know, a glass of wine, a glass of champagne.
Go for
sit
it.
Sit back and we just...
What are these?
Do
fun
you,
things
you know,
with this
sometimes
funnel?
People can be a little bit backwards in getting into... being the first into a board.
Yeah, I'm sick of that.
Do you know what I mean? Do you get in there and...
I think if you've made it and that's at your place, be the first one to get in and then everybody follows suit.
Yeah, see,
so,
really?
As we've seen you today, it's your studio, you can get in and then we'll all follow suit and follow up.
That's terrific. Thank you.
Hey, Josh, I have to ask you about this stunning assembly here. What on earth is happening here?
We just tried to make something a little bit different. So you said air it up a bit and make it a little bit more exciting for people. So what I've done is got some crostini and I've got a... goat's cheese, and then I've got some prosciutto, a nice grape, and then we've just got some rocket there. So we've got all them little flavours. We've got the saltiness, the sweet, we've got the crunch.
May I?
And then, look, just before we do
it, I'll go on.
Just put a nice
So little... that's what you've done there for the uninitiated.
Honey.
That's a slivered grape. You've sliced it in half and a little dollop of honey.
One mouthful, straight in.
One in,
straight in.
Okay.
You've nailed that. Thank you so much.
One mouthful was ambitious.
Much, sorry, but
you've
got to taste it all, though, then, don't you?
Thank you so much for coming in. Magnificent. And the full recipe will be over on the Sunrise website, as well as more information about all of the Australian Charcuterie Excellence Awards winners.